Hello, welcome to my channel, Saskia Smit here. Here you see a piece that I did last time and you wanted to know more about that. So I'm doing a new piece today and I also do some resin art on top of it. Although I liked it the way it was, but well, what you need are color art primary elements. That's a dry paint system. And I'm going to show you here how you mix them. You need the color art Vivid Art Fluid. It is an extender actually, but in this case I use it to mix my primary elements dry paint system in it. Here you see an example. It's a dry powder. It's beautiful, it's sparkly and very pigmented. So I will show you now with one color how I mix it. So I put some art fluid in a jar. As you can see, it's very fluid. It's just like milk, very thin. And why did I do this? Well, I wanted to do something else than pouring with acrylic paints, and I just thought I will try this, why not? And I actually liked it very much. So what you do is just mix one or two scoops primary elements in it. I think I used about 1 ounce there, that's 30 milliliters. And it dissolves immediately, as you can see. And there you go. And keep in mind, the colors that you use will dry very differently with this technique. But I really like the way it looks, because in the end result is very shimmery. And well, it looks a little bit like watercolor. But I really, really love doing this. So here you will see me pour all kinds of colors on there. I use a brush to divide them a little bit. I have to say, with this painting I used too much fluid, because my canvas was very loaded, so the colors got a chance to move a lot, and at the end even some colors, well, they look a little muddy. It's not mud, but I could have used less, but I had to use my brush more. But I will do that next time. For me it's experimenting also. And I hope you will enjoy this video. So I will show you step by step how I did it. And I'm sorry that it took so long for me to make a new video, but well, most of people who know me from Facebook know I'm very busy, and I'm really trying to do more on YouTube. I actually think that I'm going to do a pour with my husband Rob Smith next, so I know a lot of you will like that, and we will try to do videos on a more regular base. Here I use the Snapdragon. Well, this was very tricky, because some of the Snapdragon actually turned into a brown on some parts. But it didn't look bad, but well, I think it will be easier if you will keep your colors in the same color scheme. And of course I wanted to try some contrast, but it would be easier if you do all warm colors or all cool colors, or all cool colors. But well, it turned out okay. I think my next one, because I'm going to do a next one also for you, will be with more blue and green, and I will try to use less fluid than I used this time. So here you can see the piece is still wet, but it's starting to dry a little bit. I will show you the different phases of drying. Here you can see that the yellow actually turns gold. Here you can see that I added a little bit more of the snapdragon. And you can see that the colors are mingling much more. And here you can see in the center that there's some sort of brown-red stripe there. There you see it, it's almost dry, but this was so wet, so that brown-orange you see is still wet. And you will see the dry result right now. So this is the dry result. You can see it's not really brown, it's more like the purple and red mixed into a dark red. Here you see I'm going to put resin on it. So what's very important is that your canvas is level and make sure there's something underneath to support it, so your canvas won't sag to the middle. You don't want that to happen with resin. But I actually liked it the way it was. But I thought I would also show you how you could put resin on top of it and make it so that the background will still show, but you will have a totally new piece with showing the background, and it was fun too. But I thought it was very beautiful already. And you can always paint something on top of it, or maybe embellish it a little by making more lines in it, or maybe do some gold leaf lines on it. Whatever you want to do, it's all fine. But I thought I would do a resin piece on top. The resin I use is art resin. And the ratio is one part to one part. So that's very easy. So if you would need 200 milliliters, you would use 100 milliliter of resin and 100 milliliter of hardener. Then you stir it for about 3 to 4 minutes, and then you're good to go. And you will have a working time for about, 45 minutes to an hour. This resin won't dry very quick. So first I'm using color art tints, resin art tints. So that's just to make your resin to give it a little bit of color, but not much, so you can really see through it. And that's what I wanted, because of course I want my background to show through, but the colors will also change the color a little bit or enhance the color a little bit. If you want to use resin art tints, you always have to dissolve them first in a little bit of alcohol. I used 96% alcohol. And if you then you will have a liquid color, and then you use a couple of drops in your resin to tint it a little bit, and you can make it as light or as heavy as you want to. The color you see me mixing now is actually an interference powder from Resin Arte. So that gives a very pretty metallic shine. And all sorts of shimmer in it. Very pretty. This color also. So I'm putting down some lines now. And I'm speeding this up because this was, of course, about 3 days of work. And I cut some parts out. I had to, because this video would be a couple of hours if I would show everything. And again, I thought I would use some contrasting colors. I'm not sure if I would do that next time. It turned out okay, but maybe it's better to use well, all colors in the same color scheme to, yeah, keep it more, how do you say that? More in balance. This is my embossing heat gun. It doesn't blow that hard, but it's good enough for the resin, and I'm not so scared I will burn my resin with this one, because it doesn't heat up as much as a normal heat gun would do. So I really like this one, and it's tiny, so it's not a big machine you have to hold. If you are looking for one, you can look in my Amazon shop that's below my video in the description box, and there you can find it in the shop in the list with tools and equipment. I think I put a couple in there so you can choose with different prices. So I'm putting a little bit more clear resin there. I'm using my stirring stick to make a little bit of lines and, you know, that kind of stuff in there. And with the colors you see, the more you heat them, they will, yeah, give you some special effects. They will sell up a little bit, and you cannot see it that good from far away, but from up close it looks really beautiful. But of course I will show you the end result later. Here you can see me use a spatula to do a couple of swipes and some lines. And it was a long, long time ago that I did something with resin, so I had a lot of fun. Yeah, here I'm going to use the yellow, it's a Blingit from Color Magic, also from Color Art. And that Isadora, that really sold up great, because after this I will put a heat gun on it. And in the close-up you will see that it gave some great sales, so I like that. So as you can see, the resin is more liquid now, and that's because it's more heated, and if the resin is heated it will become more liquid. And in no means I'm a resin expert, so if you are one, you can probably do a better job than I did. But here you can see that still the background is visible, and you can see all those resin art colors on top. There you can see that beautiful snapdragon in the background. Really love that color. So next we are going to do the second layer, and that will be the next day. Here you can see you get some really nice effects when you heat up that resin. So here we are the next day. I'm mixing up some colors, also some different colors. I liked it to be a little bit warmer, so all nice and warm colors. These are, again, I first put down the tints, so you can really see through those, and you can see it will enhance the color that was on there before. I really love that effect. then I will put some clear resin in between, and now I'm defining it a little bit over my canvas. So it will change the colors a little bit, but just, yeah, a little. This is the color I'm mixing now is Purple Galaxy. That's from also from Color Art, from the Galaxy Diamond collection. Those are also very sparkly resin powders with extra shimmer. So if you like a lot of bling, look at the Galaxy Diamond collection. They are really beautiful. There you can see it. You can see the shimmer and the bling already. There we have some red. Well, I'm going to let you watch this from now, from here on. So enjoy, and I'd like to thank you very much for watching my video, and I hope you will be next I hope you will be back next time, because I'm doing one again, but probably without the resin, because it will turn out nice, but it was a little bit busy, and I like to keep my paintings simple, but I wanted you to know this is also an option, and it was actually a lot of fun. I really had a lot of fun.